Hello and welcome to my Diamond Square and Procedural Map Generation game development tutorial. In this video, we'll be talking about the Diamond Square algorithm, what it is, how it works, and how to implement it. Diamond Square is a method of generating a two-dimensional height map. It's popular, easy to understand, and relatively easy to implement. The top left and top center images on screen are what your height map might look like after applying the Diamond Square. The top right and bottom left images show what the result might look like in a 3D environment. The bottom right image shows an animated version of the Diamond Square algorithm, which creates a plasma-like effect. Diamond Square requires that your height map be of size 2 to the n plus 1 in both width and height. This is due to the algorithm's recursive nature and how it breaks down the height map and performs its calculations. The image shown on screen presents a full walkthrough of how the height map is generated. First, the corners of the array are set to some random value. This creates a geometric square, where each corner of the square corresponds to each corner of the array. Second, the center value of the square we just created is set to the average of the square values plus a random small value. This is called the square step because we're using the corners of the square to calculate a new value. Third, the values surrounding the center value from the last step are set. To do this, take a look at the arrows in the image. Instead of averaging the values in a square shape, we average the values in a diamond shape. This completes one iteration through the height map. Each iteration performs one sweep of the square steps and one sweep of the diamond steps. This continues until all values in the array are set. To ensure that we understand exactly how this algorithm is working, let's step through a simulation on a 5x5 array. This array is our height map. Each black dot represents an index that has not yet been assigned any height value. The heights range between 1 and 8 on the right side of the screen refers to the minimum and maximum height values which we can use in the height map. These particular height values are only being used for the sake of simplicity. You can use whatever range you like. For example, in the demo, I used a range of 1 through 16 so I could assign more interesting graphics to my terrain. The random range will be explained soon, so let's ignore it for now. The first thing we have to do is assign a height value to each corner of the map, in place of variables x, y, z, and w. As you can see, 2, 8, 5, and 1 define our corners. Next, we need to run an iteration of our square step. If you remember from earlier, the square step tells us to take the average of the four corners of each square on the map, add a random value to it, then assign it to the center index of the square. In this case, we do the following. 2 plus 8 is 10, plus 5 is 15, plus 1 is 16. 16 divided by 4 equals 4. Before assigning the 4 to the center index, we need to first add a random value to it. This is where the random range comes into play on the right side of the screen. Our current random range is from negative 2 to 2, meaning the random number that we add to our center index should be negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, or 2. In this case, it happened to be positive 1. Since there was only one square on our map, the square step is complete. Next, we move on to the diamond step. Notice how there are four diamonds on our map. The center of each diamond is represented as the x, y, z, and w variables. These diamonds are technically only triangles, since one of their corners falls outside the boundaries of the map. Whenever this happens, we simply ignore the missing corner and take the average of the three existing corners instead. Let's step through the calculations. The variable x equals 2 plus 8 plus 5 divided by 3 plus a random value, which happened to be negative 1, which equals 4. The variable y is 2 plus 5 plus 5 divided by 3 plus a random value of 2, which equals 6. The variable z is 8 plus 5 plus 1 divided by 3 plus a random value, which happened to be negative 1, which equals 4. W is 5 plus 5 plus 1 divided by 3 plus a random value of 0, which equals 4. That's all there is to it. The diamond step is complete. Once we complete one full iteration of both the square and diamond steps, we need to decrease our random range by some amount. A good rule here is to simply divide it in half. You could also subtract a constant, divide by something other than a half, or whatever else you can think of. The greater the random range relative to your height range, the rougher and more dynamic your terrain will look. If you look at the image, you'll notice that there are four new squares on the map, and four new center indices to set, represented by variables x, y, z, and w. The math for calculating each of these values is the exact same as before, as shown on the bottom of the image. Go ahead and pause the video if you'd like to do the calculations yourself. The square step is complete. Next, the diamond step. You should be able to notice at this point that every black dot on the map represents a diamond center. You'll also notice that some diamonds in this iteration have only three corners, while some have four corners. You will have to take this into account when calculating the average for each center index. After performing each calculation and adding some random values, the diamond step is complete and every index in the array has been set. If this was being done on a computer, we could now exit the function, draw the height map to the screen, apply some colorful graphics, and view the result. Now that we have an intuition for how the algorithm works, let's move on to writing the code. A few notes before we jump into the implementation. All code shown on screen will be pseudocode. This is to ensure that I'm not being biased towards any particular programming language. Everything done here can be achieved in every language, it's just a matter of understanding the concept and translating the code. My personal example will be built in the default game engine because that's what I'm most familiar with. After we cover the implementation, I'll show off an interactive HTML5 demo that you can play around with. This demo allows you to generate maps with oceans, plains, and mountains using Diamond Square. You can also modify the randomness scaler to gain a better intuition for how it affects the results. All of my source code can be found on GitHub totally for free if you're interested in seeing exactly how I wrote the program. The Diamond Square algorithm is relatively short in terms of lines of code. The hardest part about it is coming up with a method of traversing the height map to pick out the squares and diamonds. Let's get started. We begin the function by initializing a height map whose width and height is of size 2 to the n plus 1. We then need to assign a random height value to each of the four corners of the map. Next, we define a variable called chunk size, which equals the height map size minus 1. Chunk size refers to the width of each square and diamond in the current iteration of the algorithm, minus 1. For example, look at the image in the bottom right of the screen. In this iteration, each square and each diamond has a width, so a left and right width, of 3 indices. Therefore, the chunk size here would be equal to 3 minus 1, or 2. We will use this number to increment a for loop through the height map and keep track of which square or diamond we are currently looking at. Next, we define a variable called roughness. This is the random range that we discussed earlier, which went from negative 2 to 2 and then negative 1 to 1. Keeping in line with the earlier example, I assigned a value of 2 to this variable, but of course you can use any value you like. Now that the corners, chunk information, and roughness values are all set up, we can begin traversing the height map. On line 7, we use a while loop, which terminates once the chunk size is no longer greater than 1. Inside the while loop, we define a variable called half, which is just the current chunk size divided by 2. This will come in handy when performing our calculations later. Next, we perform the square step and the diamond step. These blocks of code will be explained on the next two slides. After both steps are complete, we divide the current chunk size by 2, since each new square and diamond is only half as big as the previous iteration. We also divide the roughness by 2 to smoothen out the terrain. Now let's discuss the code that replaces the square step and the diamond step function calls on line 9 and 10. The square step is short and simple. I'll be using the image on screen to help explain the code. Notice how the x and y variables in the for loops start at the top left corner of the top left square. During the iteration in the image, the chunk size variable would be equal to 2. Note that when we increment x or y by chunk size, we always land on the next square's top left corner. For example, if we start on the 2, incrementing x by chunk size would land us on the 4. The y variable would then be incremented by chunk size, landing us on the 6. incrementing x again would land us on the 5. This process continues until all squares are complete. The code inside the for loop simply assigns the average plus a random value to the center of the current square. The diamond step is also short and simple. Instead of our x and y variables pointing to the top left of the shape, like in the square step, the x and y variables here point to the center value of each diamond, represented by the black dots in the image. The y variable in the for loop ranges from the start of the array through the end, since we have black dots on every side of the array. We increment y by only half the chunk size, because we have black dots on every row of the array instead of every second row. The x variable ranges from the center of the current diamond through the end of the array. We increment x by chunk size since the black dots are spread out horizontally by the current chunk size, which in this case equals 2. The code inside the for loop simply assigns the average plus a random value to the center of the current diamond. Okay, so this is the demo for the diamond square algorithm. I made this in the default game engine. You can find a link to this in the video description. It'll link to my GitHub page, and it has all the controls listed out. And then if you just click on the link to my website, it'll bring you here, and you can play around with this. So the first thing that you'll see is just a gray screen, like with different shades of gray. If you hold down right-click on your mouse, you can drag the screen around, and you can see different parts of the map. This map is 129 by 129 tiles in size. And you can see the different shades of gray are just the different heights. And I used heights 1 through 16, so there are 16 different shades of gray here. You can left-click to generate a new map. So you can see this map here is brighter than the last one, and it has some dark up here. Other than that, we can go to the number keys on your keyboard. If you press the 2 key on your keyboard, it'll change all of the graphics to colored, so that now we have things like oceans and lakes and grass, plains, mountains, snowy mountaintops, and stuff like that. If you press 1 on the keyboard, you can go back to grayscale. So let's stay in the colored mode by pressing 2. If you press 3 on the keyboard, you can see this thing in the bottom left corner of the screen here. It says random scalar. That is the random range from the explanation earlier. It's the roughness value that gets divided by 2 every iteration. So here we're starting at a random range of negative 7 through 7. And this is what we get. If you go down low to a very low random number, you'll see that the terrain kind of flattens out. It gets very smooth. So there's not a whole lot of roughness or randomization going on. And that might be good for some purposes, but generally you're probably going to want to go a little bit higher. So let's go up to, and each time you increase or decrease the random scalar, it's going to regenerate a new map. Let's go up to the maximum, which I made 16. And you can see that here we get a lot more roughness. For example, in the oceans, there's deeper areas and shallower areas right next to each other. And we have more islands and stuff, and the mountains are a little bit crazier. There's more elevation changes. And overall, it just looks more dynamic and more interesting, really. I think I like the higher random scalars more than flattening things out. Because you get interesting things like this, where you have kind of a hill going down from this mountain. And then you have mountain elevations changing quicker than they would otherwise. And we get things, more interesting islands and stuff like that. So let's just generate a couple more and see what we can get. So here we have kind of a messier mountain, which I don't really like. We have a big ocean down south. Up north is mostly land. Let's generate a new one. We have mountains around the edge with a little area here of grass. We have a lake up here, a mountain in the top left. You can get some really cool stuff just by playing around with this. This one's mostly mountains. Depending on what your four corner values are set to at the beginning of the algorithm is going to dictate kind of the general layout of your map. So for example, in this one, the four corners were mostly set to mountain tiles. So when it builds the rest of the terrain, it's going to mostly have mountain tiles. Up here, obviously, you have a green tile for the corner. So more of the tiles up here are going to be lower in height value than the ones over here. And let's go down to something like 10. This is also a decent area to be. There's more flatness in the terrain, as you can see. It doesn't change as much, but there's not as much, there aren't as many interesting features when you get lower with the random scaler. So you can just play around with this if you like. Those are the only controls. 1 to go to grayscale, 2 to go to colored, 3 to decrease the random scaler, and 4 to increase the random scaler. And you can go from random scaler of 1 to random scaler of 16. You can see the source code for this algorithm in the GitHub pages. If you go into the example folder on GitHub, and then you go to the file that's called go.script, go.script, in that script file, you can see that there's an algorithm. There's a function called diamond square, and that performs the algorithm, and you can kind of see how that's working if you want. And that's it for the demo.